You're watching Two for the Road
with Joe and Tammy, so join us for this adventure. Ruth B. Kirby Gilchrist Blue Spring State Park. A word of caution, this park has a 2-mile dirt road leading into the campground. It is very bumpy, so take your time. We booked campsite number 2. As you will notice, we had pulled forward into our campsite. Reason is because if you back in, the utilities and the living space would be on the wrong side of your camper. The campground itself is real simple. There is only 18 campsites to reserve for RV and tent. And then there is a separate loop for just tents of 7 sites. Here's site number 15 for what to expect when you come here. As you can see, the campground's real simple. The campsites are pretty much on top of each other, but the best sites to choose from for little room and privacy would be 14 and 17. And here is the loop that is just for tents. As you can see, they have a lot more room and privacy. And here's a quick view of the day use area with shelters, picnic tables, and barbecue grills. There is even additional pavilions at the head of the springs. There is even a small concession stand, and this is also where you will rent your canoes and kayaks. Time for Hide a Rock. If you find one of our rocks, check out episode 15 for details. Look, we added a new color. Now we'll be hiding 5 rocks per campground. Just a short distance, the springs discharge into Santa Fe River. We did paddle upstream for a little bit for some additional exploring, but the current was a little bit strong, so we turned back and headed back into the springs. And just for the record, Tammy did most of the paddling while I did the hard job of holding the camera for filming. There is a second spring called Naked Springs, but it is closed off for pedestrian use. Tammy and I took Cooper out on a short trail walk that runs along the spring run. Much of the trail was closed on this day as it was underwater from flooding. And a must-see, here is a 350-year-old cypress tree standing over 119 feet tall. Here's a rare opportunity. If you ever camp here when it's colder than 72 degrees, go down the spring in the morning. You'll see it steaming, but you have to do it right at sunrise. So the next day, shortly after breakfast, Tammy and I took opportunity to do some floating and snorkeling at the springs. Thanks for checking out our video of Gilchrist Blue Spring State Park. Check out our playlists as we have visited other springs right here in Florida. Thanks for watching. Two for the road.